The Babysitter. This was released in 2017. It's rated TV-MA or TV Mature. It's an hour and 25 minutes, so it's nice and breezy, and it can be found on Netflix. This movie stars Samara Weaving, who was just recently in the film Ready or Not, Judah Lewis, Robbie Amell, who is Stephen Amell's cousin, Mr. Green Arrow, Bella Thorne, and Andrew Batchelor. Leslie Bibb and Ken Marino are also in this film. They play as Cole's parents. This is classified as a comedy horror thriller. The premise of the film is young Cole. Cole's 12 years old. He's kind of an introvert, very quiet. He would be considered, I guess, geeky. He's very knowledgeable. He's very polite, but he doesn't have a girlfriend, doesn't have a lot of friends. His best friend is a girl named Melanie, who's the same age as he is and in the same class and grade. But besides that, he doesn't really have any friends. Cole gets picked on by his classmates. He's bullied, and he's also bullied by the neighborhood kids who like to call him names, push him down, egg his house. Cole's parents, again played by Leslie Bibb and Ken Marino, they like to go away frequently on the weekend, just a little vacation for him. When they do this, they leave Cole with a babysitter. And Cole's usual babysitter is named Bee, just like the bee that makes honey. B-E-E. Bee is this very attractive, very funny, very engaging, very outgoing and charming and witty high schooler. She's so popular, she's not scared to be geek. She's so attractive and everyone likes her and everyone is in love with her. Guys, girls, what have you. She's very charming. She has a good relationship with Cole. She encourages Cole to be more outgoing and to take chances, and she's willing to play these movie scenarios with Cole. She actually sticks up for Cole when she sees him being bullied by one of the neighborhood kids. So they have a very good friend relationship. She seems to care about him in a friendly manner, almost like an older sister. So Cole's parents are going to be going away for the weekend, and they're going to hire Bee to watch over Cole. Melanie suggests to Cole that Bee is probably having orgies in his house once he goes to sleep. But she suggests to Cole that he should stay up and sneak out of bed and see what takes place in his own house once Bee thinks that he has gone to bed. And she dares him to do this, and he says that he will. So Bee makes Cole promise that he's going to stay in bed, that he's going to listen, he's not going to leave his room, that he's going to go to bed. He acts like he falls asleep. A couple of hours later, Cole hears people coming into his house, and it's fellow high schoolers. It's the popular high school kids. You got the quarterback, you got the cheerleader. So Cole does suspect that there's going to be an orgy that takes place. He sees this kind of geeky, shy guy come in with these popular kids. This is the same guy that he saw Bee with earlier that day. They're playing a game of spin the bottle, and at the same time, it's spin the bottle and incorporating truth or dare. So spin the bottle, and if it lands on you, you got to pick a dare or a truth. And there's some making out. So Cole does believe, like, oh shit, yeah, this is an orgy going to be taking place in my home. What this turns out to be is this is actually a sacrifice party. Bee has brought this young man to Cole's house so they could sacrifice him and use his blood as an innocent. Bee is into satanic rituals, and she has brought other people here who must make a sacrifice so they can get what they want most in the world, be it popular or good at sports or what have you. That's the whole reason that this young man was brought there. And then chaos ensues. So the premise of the film is nothing too serious. And if you're looking for a serious horror film, especially in the month of October when it's fun to watch these kind of movies, this is not the movie you're looking for. This is more of a comedy with elements of horror in it. And I wouldn't even really consider it a comedy horror, though that's what it's kind of the genre that it's put in. But it focuses more on jokes with a little bit of what they believe are scares here and there. Best film to compare this to would be Happy Death Day 2 or Happy Death Day to You. Happy Death Day 2 focuses more on comedy than the first film, where the first film did focus on a little bit more on horror. The second film focuses more on the comedy element of it. And that's what The Babysitter does here. So if you're looking for a straight up horror film, keep going. Don't let up on the gas. Drive until you find a different exit, because this is not the film for you. Andrew Batchelor, who plays John in the film, to be hilarious. I don't think I've ever seen him in a film before, and I only recall seeing him in a few Postmates commercials. But this dude, he's hilarious. If I was to rate this film and go into this film knowing it's a film that doesn't take itself seriously and it's more for fun and to watch something that's not straight up horror, I give it a 7 out of 10. It's not a horrible film. It's a fun film. It knows what it is. It doesn't try to be anything different, and it has fun with that. And I had fun with it. It wasn't anything too serious. I didn't really have to put thought into it. I just kicked back, relaxed, enjoyed it, and laughed because there's some funny parts in here. It's more funny than it is terrifying or scary. If you like what you saw in this video, please hit the subscribe button down in the right-hand corner. It's got the YouTube icon on it, and you'll get notified anytime I upload a new video. As always, I want to say thank you so much for watching this video. Thank you for your time. Thank you for letting me borrow your ears and talk about these things that I love and that I'm passionate about. Greatly appreciate it. Thank you so much. As always, be safe, be careful, and I'll talk to you soon.